Power 9 TV వీక్షకులకు నా నమస్కారాలు. జస్ట్ ఐ యామ్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ టుడే హ్యాండ్ రైటింగ్ స్కిల్స్. దట్ ఈస్ సింప్లీ వీ హ్యావ్ టు కాల్ ఇట్ యాజ్ ఏ క్యాలిగ్రఫీ. క్యాలిగ్రఫీ ఈస్ ఎ సింపుల్ వర్డ్. వీ హ్యావ్ టు లెర్న్ ఇంగ్లీష్ హౌ వీ కెన్ బి రైట్ ఇన్ ఎ బెటర్ మేనర్ ఇన్ అవర్ పేపర్ ప్రజెంటేషన్ సినారియో. సో ఇప్పుడు క్యాలిగ్రఫీ అనేది ఒక చిన్న సబ్జెక్టు. జస్ట్ వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ ఓన్లీ 26 లెటర్స్ వీ హ్యావ్. Everybody knows that the 26 letters A, B, C, D and all those things. But everybody is not similar in handwriting presentation. So coming to the topic is Kali. Kali is a word. It should be a Greek word. Kali is the sense, it's a beautiful. Graphy is a writing. So beautiful handwriting, how we can we get it? By our channel, it should be saying Easy Tips by Ramesh Dorepalli. Please watch it and you have to get it a good handwriting skills from this session. So here calligraphy is a beautiful handwriting. How we can we get a beautiful handwriting from my end? I can tell you, just you have to follow such tips and you have to get it a good handwriting. We are discussing about only 26 letters. These letters are very easy. So we have to divide the beautiful handwriting into two ways. That is, one is handwriting is divided into two. That is, one is cursive handwriting and non-cursive handwriting. Here we have to cursive in the sense we have to make connections between the letter to letter. For example, start with A, C, like this, D. It is a connection between one letter to another letter. This is called, if it is connected with one another, that should be called it as a cursive handwriting. If we are writing A, C, and D like this, this is non-cursive handwriting. We are divide that handwriting into, divide into two types. That is, one is cursive and one another one is non-cursive handwriting. If we are maintaining the connection between the letters, that should be called it as a cursive handwriting. If we are not connected one another, that should be non-cursive handwriting. Okay. Now we already is presented at the board. It is A to Z. I was divided into three zones. Letters, it should be exist in the zone level. Just how it should be existed in the zonal level, just I can show on it the board. Just you have to look and you have to follow as it is. There has a four rules. Everybody is following for handwriting. We have to maintain the four rule notebook. Everybody knows that. But how we can we implement in our notebook scenario, nobody knows. So we have to segregate the letters first. Then step by step, I can give the analysis. For example, you have to take it the letter A. It should be, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's the four rules. Just four rules, everybody knows the notebook. But how it should be existing between the lines, we need to know that things, and we have to give letter to letter analysis. Then only we have to achieve our goal. That is called, our goal is what? Good handwriting. How we can we get a good handwriting? Step by step, it is a step by step, then I can give the analysis by the step by step. Just you have to follow as it is. Just everybody have the names, like Ramesh, my name is Ramesh. Like that, there has a four rules. We have to give each line should be divided into four names. That is, first line is upper line, second one is headline, third one is baseline, and last one is lower line. So the lower line, these four are the very important to learn the concept of handwriting. Just we need to know how it should be existing in the lines, each and every letters. So please try to understand what exactly I am saying. Just as it is, you can follow, then you can be achieve our good handwriting skills. Then coming to our topic is non-cursive handwriting. I am telling you, just you have to, for example, if it is existing between these two lines, that is called a mid zone. This is called mid zone, zones. Then it should be existing between upper line and baseline. That should be called it as a upper zone. Then it should be existing between these two lines. If it is touches the head and lower line, we can call it as a mid zone. Sorry, lower zone. These are the three zones. These 26 letters are existing in these three zones only. So for example, if you are taking a example of, for example, A, letter A should be existing between line, headline and baseline. It should be existing, A is existing in this particular region. But the children are writing in the different manners. If it is touching the baseline and headline, mandatory need to touch this letter, that should be called it as a mid zone. If it is crossed like this, A, it's a wrong. Right and wrong, nobody knows, because children, if nowadays children are finished the homework or not, that is our intention of the parents. So you have to check that. If it is that person is written, is it correct or not, just you have to check one another, and you have to give the analysis how A is existing in this baseline and headline. You have to check. This is the mid zone letter. It should not be crossed either upper line nor lower line. It should be stick it for only middle zone. So middle zone, most of the letter A, C, E, I, M, N, O, R, S, U, V, W, X and Z. These letters are existing in this middle zone itself. You got my point? Middle zone in the sense it's a small region on the four rules. It should be exist in this particular region only. So these letters should be stick it for this headline and baseline only. It should mandatory touch the headline and baseline itself. Then if you are taking the example of, for example, if you are touches upper line, for example, you have to take the example of B, it should be touches the baseline, not like this. It's a wrong. Otherwise, if you are written like this, this is also wrong. So what is the right one is here? It should be need to touches the upper line and it should be touches the baseline. It should be mandatory existing between the upper line and baseline. This is called upper zone letter. For example, you have to take it as example B, H, F, L and T. These are the upper zone letters, and D also. Already I was written here B, D, F, H, L and another more letter is T. It should be touches the upper line. So that is called it as upper zone letters. Then coming to the next point is lower zone. For example, I was completed mid zone and upper zone and lower zone. Already everybody understand. Now it is touches, for example, this is the four lines. If it is touches, example Y, it is touches the lower line. If it is touches the lower line, then we can call it as a lower zone letter. So we have to segregate it. For example, so many letters are not there. Here only 26 letters. We have to divide into three rows. That is a set one is middle zone, set two is upper zone, set three is lower zone. These are the main concepts, and we have to divide and segregate the letters, and we have to adjust with these lines only. Either it should not be cross the upper line, it should not be come down to the lower line. It should be existing these four lines only. We should not deviate anything. Then we have to maintain these 26 letters in these four lines only. Then we have to practice letter by letter. Then only we can get the success. Otherwise, if you are practicing in the bulky way and if you are writing the paragraph or something else, we should not get it anything that relevant to the handwriting. We have to learn each and every letter first. Then touches with the another letter. We need to know step by step each and every letter, how it be getting. It should be oval shape. This is another shape. Shapes of the letter should not be changed as per your convenience. There has a letter, a specific shape is there. We have to maintain that specific shape and specific structure and specific area. These are the areas are there. This is upper zone, mid zone and lower zone, and lines are there. We should not cross that lines, and we need to put it inside the letters and lines only. So then only we have to give the perfect structure to the letter. And while we are maintaining this letter to letter, for example, if you are starting with the single letter, if you know the single letter, you have to try for the two word letter. For example, two word letter is O and on is there. For example, O and on, O here, N here. If it is connecting between these two letters, that should be O and on, it should be meaningful. If it is the letter, two letter words only, you have to try. After finishing of the single letter, you have to start it with two letter words, then three letter words, then four letter words. Like that we have to improve. Directly if you are writing a paragraph, that should be very tough task, and we should not be maintaining a good connection between the letters. While I am telling about the non-cursive handwriting now itself, then I can be discuss about the cursive handwriting also. Then